In the introduction of Volume 1 of Democracy in America, Alexis de Tocqueville begins by focusing on what he identifies as his central impression during his stay in the United States, the equality of conditions there. He remarks that democracy seems to be making rapid advances in Europe as well, and that a new political science is needed for a world altogether new. France has abolished aristocratic society, but has not thus far replaced it with a satisfactory or stable alternative. It's only in America that the great social revolution, or upheaval, culminating in equality of conditions, has reached its natural limits. Tocqueville explains that he traveled to America in search of practical lessons about the nature and functioning of democracy. Democracy in America is the outcome of the author's quest to discover what we ought to hope or fear from a democratic system of government. In his introduction, Tocqueville also briefly summarizes his methods, commenting on his use of written documents and his numerous interviews with the most enlightened men he could consult. In Volume 1, Chapter 1, External Configuration of North America, Tocqueville focuses on a geographic overview, what he calls the external configuration of North America, the Rockies and the Alleghenies, the Mississippi River, and its valley, which are located in between. Tocqueville envisions the first landings in America by the Europeans, and he goes on to describe the boundless wilderness and its Native American inhabitants. He closes the chapter reaffirming his description of North America as a wilderness at the time of the first European contact. Although the Native Americans occupied the land, according to him, they did not possess it. Tocqueville highlights equality, the social and political landscape in Europe, and foreshadows a keynote contrast between equality and aristocracy. Sometimes presented as a contrast between democracy and aristocracy, juxtapositions to which he will return on numerous occasions. But although he will reveal himself to be generally favorable toward democracy, Tocqueville has many criticisms and foresees significant dangers in this system of government. In sharp contrast to such rhetorical passages, however, are regressive sayings summarizing the Native Americans' relationship to the land of North America. The graceful interweaving of these disparate stylistic elements, all three of which are exemplified in the opening section, is an important aspect of Tocqueville's achievement as a political theorist and his sophistication as a writer.